Good afternoon. The first item of business this afternoon is time for reflection. And our time for reflection leader today is Professor Rowan Croft, Professor of Philosophy, University of Stirling.
Thank you. So, Presiding Officer, MSPs, thank you for inviting me. I work in philosophy at Stirling University. Philosophy can mean slow, careful attention to what we already know. And today, I'll attend to the politician's familiar idea of rights. Scotland has notable rights achievements, including incorporation of the UN Convention on the Rights of the Child. And one important question asks, what are the practical effects on children's lives of such measures? A philosophical question asks about the effects on our thinking. What difference does it make to our view of children if we think of them as right holders? What's the value of seeing anyone as a right holder? I'll argue that rights, and especially human rights, matter in our thinking because they show that the individual must not be sacrificed for the sake of society. So many concepts give guidelines for behaviour, including duties, goals, ideals. The Ten Commandments list duties, ways that people should behave. The Sustainable Development Goals list goals, aims that states should pursue. And when we use the concept of a right, we add something extra to this idea of a rule, or a duty or a goal. We give a special status to an individual person or a group as a right holder, a status as the person who's wronged if the duty is violated, the person who has standing to demand the duty's fulfilment. And sometimes we'll create this status just because it's efficient to do so. Think about the rights created by car parking regulations. Karl Marx worried that rights are dangerously individualistic, focusing attention on powerful claimants at the expense of duty bearers. And he might be correct when it comes to some of the rights that define markets. But human rights aren't like this. They're justified independently of efficiency or social usefulness. They mark a mutual recognition of our common humanity, protecting individuals against being exploited or abandoned. So when we see the duty not to torture or to provide healthcare as securing human rights, we are recognising each person as mattering independently of whether respecting them is good for the wider group or serves other values. And I think in this way, human rights are anti-fascist. They give a person a special moral and legal status, meaning they're unsacrificable for wider society. And this is a vital feature. It springs from how rights highlight individual claimants and also from how human rights are justified by what they do for the individual right holder. I wanted to remind you, our elected representatives, of the essential value in thinking of people as right holders. Thank you for listening.
Thank you.